Hi, I'm Hannah Shamloo, and I'm a PhD candidate in the School of Earth and Space Exploration at Arizona State University. I'm an igneous petrologist, which is a flavor of geologists that studies magma, how magma's formed, how it evolves, and how it sometimes erupts on the surface. The mantle is the most massive layer inside the Earth, and it's also where magma's formed. To be clear, the mantle is solid rock and not liquid as commonly mistaken. And it's also moving or convecting. This convection causes the rigid skin or the crust sitting on top of the mantle to drag. We call this plate tectonics on the surface. So if the mantle's solid, you're probably wondering, how do we form liquid magma? There are three main ways to melt the mantle and form magma: spreading centers, subduction zones, and hotspots. Spreading centers are where two tectonic plates are moving away from each other. This causes an opening, allowing for hot, buoyant mantle material to rise through this new opening. As the mantle material rises, it experiences a pressure reduction, going from a high pressure mantle to a low pressure crust. This pressure reduction actually causes the mantle material to melt. Another way we can form magma is through subduction zones. Subduction zones are when two tectonic plates are moving towards each other. This causes the denser plate to dive underneath the more buoyant plate. The denser plate typically is full of volatiles. These are chemical compounds such as water or carbon dioxide. The addition of volatiles into the mantle causes the melting temperature of the mantle to decrease. This decrease in melting temperature causes the mantle to melt, forming magma. The third way to form magma is by hotspots. Hotspots are hot columns of rock that can extend as deep as the core, which is 1,800 miles beneath our feet. Hotspots form magma in a similar fashion to spreading centers, only the melting happens deeper in the mantle because of the hot column of rock. Geologists typically think of Hawaii and Yellowstone as examples of hotspot volcanoes. So now we understand how magma forms and how it erupts, but why should we care? Over 600 million people live close enough to a volcano to experience its effects. By understanding past volcanic eruptions, we can be better prepared for future volcanic eruptions and potentially avoid the hazards that they pose.